Well, it appears federal dollars meant for Montana hospitals are coming in, but are falling short. The nation's hospitals, the front line in the battle against the coronavirus, are in line to get more than $50 billion from Congress's new CARES Act to help respond to the pandemic. But so far, those dollars have been slow to arrive. And now a new study reveals hospitals that primarily serve the poor got the smallest share of the money. Q2's Jay Cohn gets down to the bottom of it in tonight's Montana Rebound report.
The study by the Kaiser Family Foundation included more than 4,500 hospitals nationwide. The bottom line, Congress based the CARES Act financial help on a hospital's revenue, not a hospital's need. The result, a sharp disparity among hospitals serving a majority of private insurance patients versus those with a high percentage of uninsured patients. Boiled down to per bed costs, hospitals with a high percentage of private payees received as much as $44,000 per bed, while hospitals doing more charity work and serving as teaching facilities received less than half of that, $20,000 per bed. In Montana, it's a little different scenario, but still a case where it appears the CARES Act dollars may have missed the mark.
We had the lowest distribution of this last run of any state in the country. And we also happen to have the lowest incidence of disease. So we took on a lot of expense. We made major adjustments to operations to bring in the best approaches in public health. And we were successful in keeping the disease out of the state, but it didn't come without a cost. And unfortunately, you know, the flow of dollars to date really has penalized highly efficient states like Montana.
When hospitals canceled all elective surgery to focus on preparing for COVID-19, their costs went up while revenue dried up.
Pre-CARES Act dollars, our loss was $13.44 million for the first 5 months of the year. And then the CARES Act dollars we received in April, we did recognize as income, and that was $10.64 million. So our overall loss now year to date through May, and your timing's perfect because we truly just have the financials through May, so fairly timely information, would be a $2.8 million loss at this point of the year.
Meanwhile, just down the street at Billings Clinic, the books here have been in the red for 3 months in a row. They're hoping that this month, the month of June, they'll finally make it back into the black. CEO Scott Elner says the financial impact of COVID-19 hit hard.
We've determined we've lost about $42 million in net revenue, which was a significant impact due to canceling of elective surgeries, shutting down our clinics, and really figuring out at the same time that we wanted to keep people employed. So we did not do any layoffs or furloughs.
In April, the clinic received $14 million in CARES Act funds, which helped, but that covers only about one-third of the clinic's cost. Both Elner and Pelagi credit the CARES Act dollars in helping both hospitals avoid layoffs or furloughs. In fact, Elner told us he was surprised at how fast the federal funds arrived. Looking forward, though, fingers are crossed, as no one really knows for sure what's next. Rich Rasmussen at the Montana Hospital Association says buckle up for some tough days ahead.
This is a marathon. It's not a sprint. It would be very different if we had a vaccine in place, and we don't. And we know, too, it's, you know, at the same time that we have the likelihood of the COVID-19 surging in the fall, it's going to come the same time as we have traditional flu. So we'll have this confluence of infectious diseases potentially hitting us at the same time.
In Billings, I'm Jay Cohn reporting for MTN News.
And Jay says both hospitals face a big challenge to replace the lost revenue. As you heard, the clinic estimates its net revenue loss by about $42 million. By comparison, for St. Vincent, about $33 million. So both say they've been reimbursed about a third of their expenses.